Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain about Ohm's law. So this is an experiment on Ohm's law. So for doing this experiment we need these are the parts. So these are the items. One is DC power supply, next one is the multimeter, next this is rheostat, which is a variable resistance, and last one we need one voltmeter. So we can also connect a multimeter in place of a voltmeter. So for performing this experiment, so we have to follow the procedure. Our procedure is like this. At first we have to, so this is the connection diagram. So here, okay, first let me explain the connection diagram. First here, so from the circuit diagram it is observed that from power supply one connection is coming to the emitter. So this is our emitter, this multimeter is acting as emitter. Again the other point of the emitter, which is connected to the rheostat. Again the ending point of the rheostat is connected to the power supply. So this is the connection diagram for performing the Ohm's law. So now we are going to the procedure. So in the procedure, first of all we have to set the power supply as well as the emitter in zero. Nextly we have to increase the voltage of power supply by 5 in the interval of 5. So I am gradually increases. So when it becomes 5 or near about 5, so there will be one current reading corresponding to that voltmeter voltage. So it is observed, it is showing in the multimeter. So from the multimeter we can note down it for a particular set of reading. Nextly again we increases the voltage to 10 volt. So when it is showing in 10 volt in the DC supply, so here our current is also changes. So it is there is a reading showing corresponding to this voltage. So like this we have to proceed for 15 volt. So for 15 volt also. For 15 volt also there is one corresponding reading of current. So like this we have to go for the 30 volt, as this power supply limits up to the 30 volt. So we will get 6 sets of reading. After taking the reading we plot this voltage and current in a graph that is called VI graph, and we are getting one parameter. That parameter is called resistance, that is that can be calculated by V by I. So after, in our next video, so we will discuss about the result of this experiment. So what will be the graph shape and what we can find it from this table. So we will discuss all this in our next video. So thank you.
Thank you.